Most of the services these days are created using microservice architecture, and Docker helps a lot in managing and shipping these services. So let's see how we can create Docker images using GitHub Action. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Mayank and I am a software developer. Today we will try to create a Docker image and publish it to a private registry. In our previous video, we have seen how we have created a general workflow to run a Python file. Okay. So as you can see here, we have this private repository named as Actions Demo, and we are going to create a Docker image and we will push it to this registry. Okay, one more thing, Docker is providing the service of creating the image as you have any change in your source code, but this service is chargeable as it is only available with pro, team and business subscriptions. But we can do the same thing using Actions without any charges, but there is certain limit to running the GitHub Actions, which we can check via the documentation. Now let's check out the Docker file. Here is the Docker file in which we are taking Python as base image and then copying the content, changing the work directory and installing the requirements, and then a simple entry point script. So this is just a basic Docker file. Okay, and we can also check the entry point script. It is running our Python file, and here it is adding the output to this code.txt file. Now let's create the workflow. Here, click on Actions, New Workflow, and here we have this template to create the Docker image. Okay, on checking this out, we can see that this will be triggered on push and pull request to the main branch, and we have this steps here as checking out the code and building the Docker image. But only building the Docker image won't do much help. We need to log in to the private registry, and also we need to push the Docker image. So before building the image, we need to add a step for Docker login. We can check it from the marketplace. Here we have this step. Okay, I will copy this. Now need to correct the indentation. Okay, Docker login uses this action. Now registry. Server address of Docker registry, if not set, then default will be Docker Hub. Since ours is Docker Hub, we can remove this. It will choose Docker Hub on its own. Okay, username, I will provide my username. Here it is, my Sony. And for password, we'll just get back to it. Specifies whether the given registry is ECR. ECR is basically, I think it is Elastic Container Registry from AWS, but since it is not, we can make it false. And log out from Docker registry at the end of the job. Yeah, we do want that, and the default is true. So either I can just go for true here, or I can remove it, that's okay. Now for password, it is advised not to use the passwords directly here because we are going to push this template on GitHub and it is not safe. So for this, we will open the settings in a new tab. And these are the settings particularly for my repository, this one. And here I will go to secrets. I'll go to action. I'll click on create new repository. Secret. Okay. And here I will mention Docker password. Okay. And as secret, I will write down the secret and click on add secret. Okay, now it is updated. Once you add this Docker password, no one in your team can edit this. Only they can update it or they can delete it. Okay, and so your secret is encrypted and safe here. And you can use these secrets either as environment variable or you can directly use it as password, like what we are going to do now. Now next is the building the Docker file, and this is simply a shell command. And here we need to change this to our registry name. After this one, I will add another step to push the Docker image. So I will name it and then run the command docker push the image. Now since our workflow is complete, we will try to commit it. And as soon as I commit this workflow, since it will be a push event to the main branch, our workflow will be triggered. Commit directly to main, yes. Now we can go to actions. We can check this one. It is building. Docker login is successful. Building the image. These steps are looking fine. And now it is pushing the Docker image. So if we will check here on our registry, we can see that this image has been pushed a few seconds ago. That's all for today. If you have learned something new, please like this video and share it with your friends. If you have any questions regarding this, please let me know in the comment section.